Hi, this is Amit Agarwal from Digital Inspiration, and as you may know, Facebook has recently allowed embedded posts. That means you can take any public content on Facebook and embed it onto your website. Now, for instance, if your favorite sports celebrity has shared a photo on Facebook, you can take that photo and embed it on your website. Similarly, if a news organization has shared some breaking news on Facebook, you can share their status update onto your blog. But there is a small catch. Now, initially, Facebook has rolled out the embedded post functionality to a very small set of publishers, including the Huffington Post, CNN, Mashable, etc. So how do we small publishers get to use embedded post? Now, here's a very simple workaround, but before I share that, let's look at an example. This page contains two embedded posts, a photograph and a video that I shared on my Facebook page. Now, Facebook has obviously not approved my account for embedded posts, yet I am able to embed my content onto my website. How I do that? That's very simple. So I'll switch to my Facebook page and let's pick one status update or even a photograph that I want to share on an external website. Now let's pick this one on Chrome DevTools. Now all status updates on Facebook have a date associated with them. Now when you right click this date, you get the permanent link to that status update. So first right click this link and copy it to the clipboard. Next, I'll switch to the code of this HTML page. Now you can find the snippet in the show notes, and all I have to do is change one little thing in this code. Your URL here, I have to replace this with the URL that I just copied to the clipboard. I'll just make that change, save the changes, and let's see what happens when I refresh this page in the browser. And here's that embedded Facebook post. It was so simple, right? Okay, now let's try something different. I'll switch to my Facebook personal profile, and this time we'll embed a photograph. So I'll pick a photograph and then right click the date associated with that photograph to copy the permanent link of that Facebook post. Once the link is copied, I switch to the code editor and I need to replace that URL in that FB post element with the new URL. Alternatively, if I want to have both the status updates on the same web page, I'll create another FB post element, but this time the href value would be equal to the link address that I just copied to the clipboard. I save the code changes and then I switch to the web page and I'll reload it to test whether those have arrived or not, and yes, they have. So it was so simple to embed Facebook content on external websites without you having to be an approved publisher. Thanks.